Hey guys, Vince Nero here, Content Marketing Manager with Siege Media. Today I'm going to talk to you about finding someone's email address online. If you're watching this video, you've probably already felt the pain and stress from trying to find someone's email address. It can be frustrating, it can be really time consuming, especially if you're coming up empty. So hopefully today I can give you some tips and some tactics and some tools that are going to help speed that process up and make you more successful. So let's jump in. The very first one is going to be a tool I like to use pretty much daily. It's called Walla Norbert. And this is a Chrome and web app. I mainly use the Chrome extension while I'm actually prospecting for emails. So you can just pop in the name and the first name and the last name on the domain that you're in, and Norbert will search its database and it'll spit out an email. You have 50 of them for free, so if you want to give it a try, it's a great tool. But if you don't like paying, you could try another tool. And the other one I use is Hunter. So Hunter is very similar. It's a Chrome plugin. This one, what I like about it, what it does differently from Norbert, is it automatically displays emails that it's already found on the page. So you go to your domain, pop up the Norbert app, and it'll display emails it's found. And if you're not seeing what you're looking for, you can also, like while on Norbert, you can also type in the first and last name, and it'll query its database and see if it can find something for you. Again, like Norbert, this one's got 150 per month free, so there's a cap on it, but it's a great tool. Both of those are great, quick Chrome plugins. Next one is a tool that is paid only, but it's a great service that we use here at Siege. It's called BuzzStream. It's great for large and outreach PR campaigns because it lets you track the emails that you're sending. But what it does in our case is, similar to Norbert and Hunter, it's going to search in the domain itself to help uncover some emails. If BuzzStream isn't your thing, this next one that you can try if you're not looking for a paid subscription is, it's kind of like a quasi-tool slash resource, and it's LinkedIn's Sales Navigator, and you use it in conjunction with a resource that was created by Distilled called the Email Permutator. So as you know, most big sites have a discernible pattern in the way that they put an email address. So it might be the first name and the last name at domain.com. And once you can identify that, it makes it a little easier. So what the issue can be sometimes is identifying those patterns. So Email Permutator kind of takes some of that out of the equation, and it's a Google sheet that you can download. You pop in the first name and the last name, and you run the sheet, and it will spit out all the different permutations of that email. So for instance, if I put in Vince Nero, it would do Vince Nero. Say I put Vince Nero at gmail.com, it would VinceNero@gmail.com, VNero@gmail.com, VN@gmail.com, and so on and so forth. What the LinkedIn Sales Navigator actually does in this scenario is, if you're using it with Gmail, which is how LinkedIn Sales Navigator integrates with your email, you can pop in some of these emails that the permutator is putting out for you. And if that person is using that email to log into LinkedIn, their name will show up, so then you know you have a match. You're kind of out of luck if that person's using a different email for LinkedIn, so you can move on to some of these other tips. And the next one that kind of bridges this gap nicely is these couple tactics I have for finding email patterns. So like I said, most sites are going to have patterns, and typically, you're going to find this in large-scale companies. Smaller ones, not so much. I like to use a tool called Email Format. You can actually go there, type in the domain name, and it'll spit out what it thinks is the discernible pattern for that particular site. If that's not working for you, you get to know some of these patterns. So one of them that you would see for maybe an individual journalist or a blogger a lot of the times is, if they have a site, for instance, I own the domain VinceNero.com, so a lot of the times you'll see a first name at domain.com, so Vince@VinceNero.com. That's sometimes a sure bet for a journalist or an individual, just because it's kind of a easy, simple email address that someone will make right off the bat. And once you kind of decide that this is the email route you want to go, it's nice to be able to verify it before you send the email. That way you're going to avoid annoying Google mailer daemon saying that it's undeliverable. So there's actually a couple tools you can use to verify these emails. And one of them is simple verifyemail.org. Another one's called Email Hippo. And you just pop in the email and it'll query the database and it'll tell you if it's an actual active email address. You know, if you're actually coming up empty with all those tools, not to worry. You can head over to Google. What you're actually going to do is query Google to search through Twitter and see if your person, your target, has actually mentioned their email in a tweet. So a lot of the times somebody will ask a journalist, hey, how can I get in touch with you? And they'll say, try me at this email address. And so you're searching Google, you're going to put in twitter.com/their username and the word email. And so that'll uncover it if they've actually mentioned it. So if they haven't, not to worry, you can actually just get into some Google search operators. It's simple stuff like their name and the word email, or their first name and last name in quotes and the word contact. Or you can try site:the domain or website you're looking at and the word email or the word contact. That can help uncover some things that you might not have already found. Last tactic is going to be trying Facebook. Now, again, this isn't going to work for everybody. Some of the large-scale brands aren't going to necessarily put their individual emails on there, but for a small blogger, you might be able to find a nice usable email under the About tab in their Facebook page. Again, like, you might get lucky with a big company. You might find a social contact, like a social@site.com, or maybe an About support sometimes, but honestly, it's way better for smaller bloggers. So yeah, I mean, that's it. That's the 10 tips. And if you stuck with me this long, I wanted to just kind of impart one last tip overall. And it's important to think of when you're finding these email addresses. And it's basically the easier it is to find someone's email address, that means more people around have probably already found it as well. So you're up against a little more competition. So that just means you have to really personalize the email, make sure you spend some time and make sure it's not something that sounds like it's a canned email response or an email blast. That's it. And thanks for watching. If you guys like the video, please appreciate it if you gave us a thumbs up, subscribe, and leave any thoughts in the comments. Thanks, guys.